Ho, ho, ho. My name is Margarita Velasco.
And I'm Brendan Leahy.
And we are once more live from the Roundtable, Christmas edition.
All I want for Christmas is you.
To start things off, I wonder how the weather is up at the North Pole.
Well, wonder no more. We got our special knights, Michael and Mark. Take it away.
Hey, Margarita. We're up here. We're looking for Santa's workshop, and we haven't seen it yet, but oh my god, it's so cold up here, man. You got anything to say? Because I don't know.
I'm an idiot. I should have brought a sweater or something made of this vest.
Yeah, what are you doing up in like a vest and a t-shirt up in the North Pole, dude? It's like probably like below zero here. What, you're something else, man.
Oh, man, have you seen my hat?
No, you had a hat?
I don't know. I kind of lost in the blizzard.
Oh my god. Oh. Well, say goodbye to your hat.
Okay. Oh. You left your hat at home.
Thank you. That, cool. Oh, dang, man, it's freezing out here.
Okay, well, we're gonna keep looking for Santa's workshop, but we'll send it back to you, Margarita. Oh my God, that's a polar bear! Run!
Thank you, Michael. It's the most festive time of the year, and what's more festive than ugly sweater on Christmas Day?
Aiden Big Hoss Kane is headed down to the cafeteria to show what HHS has to offer for some of the best ugly sweaters last week.
Hi, I'm Aiden Kane, and I'm from Live from the Rad Table. And today, I'm going to go around and check the cafeteria just to see who has the best ugly sweater. Hi, what's your name?
Kenny.
Why do you think you have the most ugly sweater here?
Because I don't see no one else with a lit hat like me, you know? And nobody else really has lights, so.
All right, thanks, my man.
Thank you.
Hello, what are you guys' names?
Samantha. Caitlin.
And why do you think you guys have the best ugly sweaters here?
I think my ugly sweater is better than everyone else's just because of all the different colors, and it's so festive. And on top of it, like, it's itchy, which makes it even more uglier.
Mine lights up, so it's automatically better than Sam's. And yeah. Yeah.
All right, thanks for your time. Hey, what's your name?
John.
All right, John, why do you think you have the best ugly sweater here?
Blue is a very ugly color.
Thanks for your time. Guys, what are you guys' names?
James.
Jalissa.
And why do you guys think you have the best ugly sweaters here?
Well, a lot of people wear the same sweater as me, but they just don't wear it like I do, so mine is the best.
Mine's the best because I'm single and ready to jingle, so.
Nope.
Wow, thanks for your time, guys. This has been Aiden Kane from the Roundtable, signing off.
Thanks, guys. In other news, Senator Eileen Dunhue stopped by Holyoke High this week to take questions from the students about her career.
Senator Dunhue is a Holyoke High graduate. She came in to talk to a few of our classes and was invited by Mr. Dunhue and Mrs. Butler.
Hi, I'm Aiden Kane, and I'm here with Senator Eileen Dunhue, and I'm just here to ask a couple questions. So, what was it like going to HHS as a student?
You know, it was great. I had come from smaller schools, so coming to Holyoke High School was a much larger school, but I loved it. You know, it offered so many opportunities. And, you know, we had a lot of amenities that you may take for granted now, but some of the brand new labs and things that were in place, it was a pretty cool place to go to school.
All right, thank you. And how do you think going to Holyoke High has affected your career as a whole?
You know, going to Holyoke High School, I think, prepared me for so many things. As I said, the student body is diverse, and it certainly opened my eyes to the opportunities. Not only in terms of going then on to even bigger school at the University of Massachusetts in Amherst, but having the broadened outlook of trying to take advantage of educational opportunities and then eventually moving to Boston for law school and having a law career and then later a political career.
The Christmas season is one of the most wonderful time of the year, yet it can be very stressful for some people.
All that decorating and gift giving should have that up, eh?
To help make sense of all this, we have Tony with some special tips about the Christmas season.
Oh, hey, I'm Tony from Tony's Tips, and here are four Christmas tips. Tip number one, get Christmas lights inside and outside of your house, and you know, get a Christmas tree, decorate it. Tip number two, listen and sing along to Christmas music, because you know, it spreads Christmas cheer to everyone. Tip number three, leave cookies and milk out for Santa. As we all know, Santa is real, and there's 100% proof that he is real. I'm not going to get into that now, but just make sure you leave cookies and milk out for him.
He's not real.
Yes, he is. Final tip, give. It's the season of giving, so get out there, buy stuff for your loved ones, or do a generous act. Merry Christmas.
Cheers, Tony. With the holiday break upon us, our reporters Brianna and Aggie want to know what your Christmas and New Year's wishes are.
I'm Brianna Guay, and we're live from the Roundtable. I'm here with Mr. Shanahan. What's your New Year's resolution?
My New Year's resolution, my friend, is just to wake up and live another day and give thanks for that day.
Hi, I'm here with Julissa Roldan, and what would you like for Christmas?
I want to get into my favorite college for Christmas.
What is your favorite college?
Connecticut College.
I hope you get in.
Thank you.
Hi, Mr. Graney. What would you like for Christmas?
For a few people I know that are battling cancer, for them to get healthy. That would be nice.
I'll be praying for them too.
It's appreciated.
Hi, I'm here with Mr. Marks, and just one question. What's your New Year's resolution?
Oh, geez, thanks for the... My New Year's resolution will be to hit the gym a little bit more, get back into health and fitness, maybe start doing my 5K runs every once in a while. I can commit to that.
That's a good resolution.
Thanks, Bree. Yeah,
thank you.
Hi, I'm here with Mr. Corshane, and what would you like for Christmas?
Grapes.
Grapes? Green? Purple?
Purple.
I respect that.
The holiday season is all about traditions. With that in mind, we are here at the Roundtable wanting to start a new tradition, a gingerbread house competition.
Which team will come out on top? Troy and Giancarlo's helped referee the Clash of Titans. Let's see how it went down.
Hey guys, welcome to the first annual gingerbread house making contest by the Roundtable, and we have two teams featured here, the Foes and the Temptations. Get to your position. So you guys have 5 minutes to build that gingerbread house. Get ready, set, go. Halfway over, 2.5 minutes left. Give it up for the Temptations.
All right, Temptations, come on, celebrate. We get a clap, everybody. Yes.
Go,
And this is going to do it for the Gingerbread House competition, and we will see you guys next time. Thank you for watching.
Well, that's going to do it for us here in the studio.
To finish things off, we have a holiday-themed game corner. And of course, you can't forget the annual Holyoke High music video for Christmas.
We'd like to wish everybody out there a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year! See you in 2018.
Bro, everybody needs a nickname.
I don't care. I want the nickname.
No, you need a nickname.
Bro, you're not calling me that. Bro, no.
Hey, what's up, guys? It's your boy, Alex Beesters. He's here joined by my boy, Versace Vic.
No.
Yes. Bro, it's in the contract.
Fine.
Just okay.
One episode.
Anyways, this week we're giving you guys the top picks for presents that you can give for your favorite gamer this year.
Why do we have chairs if we're just gonna stand anyways? All right, my first pick is gonna be Destiny, Destiny 2, mostly because this MMORPG franchise broke day one sales back in 2014, reaching over $500 million. That's insane. Also, it's fun. It's a great FPS shooter, great story, depends on who you're looking for, and it's cheap, $35. Target. Great game, I recommend you get it.
Just do it!
Please.
All right, my second game is gonna be PUBG, PlayerUnknown Battlegrounds, which holds the Guinness World Record for the most consistent players on Steam. Also, it just released for Xbox One on December 12th. It's only $30, get it. I command you. All right, my third pick is gonna be Call of Duty World at War II. This franchise has sold over 250 million copies. Also, it's a great game to just chill, have fun, get a little competitive with your friends, probably swear a little bit, but you know what? As long as your mom doesn't mind, you know, it's all good. Just keep it down. Price. No, I don't know the price, right? GameStop has a sale every year during Christmas, like $30, most likely. Can't do that? Get a job. I don't know. All right, my fourth and last game is gonna be Assassin's Creed Origins. In Assassin's Creed Origins, you play as the protagonist, Bayek, and you look to avenge your late son, Kimu, who was inadvertently killed by Bayek when he was trying to get away from some evil dudes that I'm not really gonna get into because it's a whole thing. It's a great game, awesome fun, lots of exploring to do. Explore lost tombs, find treasure, and here's what a lot of people don't know. It actually has an RPG element to it, meaning you can find different swords, different weapons, different bows, and they all have different stats to them. And so if you're into that kind of thing, definitely recommend you check it out.
So talking about great games, one of the best games to come out from this year is The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild. This game has reached one of the top scores in all of the main review places ever. This game has gotten so many good reviews, everybody's getting this game, and Nintendo's gaining a bunch of money on this, gaining over 1 million sales. This game is perfect for the action RPG player that you can't really give Skyrim to, but you can definitely give a kid's game to. This game is absolutely beautiful and has the most stunning graphics I've ever seen from a Zelda game up to date. Definitely check it out if it's in your price range and if you have a Switch. So of course, just like every year, there's always 2K. Now, this year they have 2K18 with brand new features that even you will like. Trust me, the Road to 99 career mode is absolutely insane. Going from a star player in your local community to then playing on a basketball team is absolutely amazing. And especially now with the all-time teams that they added in, trust me, it's gonna be a lot of fun to play with the friends.
I got it.
Anyways, pick this up if you guys wanna have a good sports game and make sure you guys can beat me on the court. Now for a game that won quite possibly the most awards at this recent Game Awards show. I'm talking about Cuphead. It's quite possibly the best indie game we have out of this year entirely. With its impeccable art style that kind of looks like something out of an 80s cartoon, it is incredibly hard and incredibly difficult to get by, but trust me, you guys are gonna love this game. This game has given way to so many different playthroughs and everybody's finding a bunch of secrets in it. Has so many fun bosses and levels that honestly you might get mad at, but you'll never get bored of. This game is great and I love playing it.
Okay, bye.
All right, so this has been it for our episode of the Game Corner. Now, make sure you guys get the best gifts for your little gamer at home. And always remember,
happy holidays and stay frosty, guys.
Yo, bro, did you bring the gift?
Yeah, I got it.
All right, cool, come on.
Prospero año y felicidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Prospero año y felicidad. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas from the bottom.
To get to the gift swap.
Oh, all right.
Rocking around the Christmas tree at the Christmas party hop. Mistletoe hung where you can see every couple tries to stop. Rocking around.